So it really depends. So Nomad and Blender, they're just completely different. Like Nomad is like an artist's, like, it's almost like Procreate. It's like a drawing app. Whereas Blender is like in my new tutorial, I have like a video talking about how Blender is like an engineer's application. Like, it seems like it was built by engineers to do like engineering things. And then there's people that wanted to do it for artsy things, like, were able to do that as well. But it doesn't feel like that was first. Like, Nomad is like, okay, I want to just like sculpt. Let me just bring in some shapes and sculpt like a person or a character. And it's fun and it's intuitive. And you can kind of feel, okay, like, I can move this around. It's easy. I can, you know, blend these things. It's really easy. Whereas with Blender, everything is like, you know, you have a keyboard, you have to learn all the shortcuts to be able to do things. You have to learn all the mouse movements, and you have to learn like what a goal is, what like a NURBS curve is, and object and add and select. And like all these things have so many different like applications. And then it's like knowing when to do edit view and object view. So it's like, it's just so much more involved that it's not really that fun. So if you're used to this kind of thing, it might be cool to just make something simple in Nomad to kind of experience how different that is from the traditional desktop apps. I'm very curious about how Nomad is going to do when it's on desktop, because whereas like it doesn't really, that, you know, that's cool. Like, I'm looking forward to trying it on desktop, but it's almost like it was the dream behind it is like, okay, this is like for iPad because the experience is so much like drawing. Like, it's more to like, okay, we can sit and like draw and we're just looking at the screen. We have our pencil. And then we're just like drawing in, but it's like 3D. So it'll be interesting to see how it is as a desktop app, because again, it's competing with all the other desktop applications. So what I think would be really awesome for Nomad is that if Nomad started incorporating some more hard surface specific tools. It doesn't have to be, I mean, obviously there's Plasticity and Blender and all the other ones that can do hard surface. But if Nomad did sort of like a simplified version of those, where it's like, it's not too in the weeds just yet. And also, I'm sure that all these applications, like, I'm sure that Nomad, as with any other applications, in time, is just going to add more things and add more things and add more things. So in 10 years, if you start using it, it's going to have like a ton of things. I understand that, but I think the next step for a lot of people using Nomad is going to be, okay, so this is what vertices and edges and faces, and this is how to manipulate them. And this is like how to inset faces and how to extrude and how to bevel. You know what I mean? Just like those things, like just those tools, I think would make sense for a desktop application. But I'd actually really love to see that on the iPad as well. But I think that would be a great update. Because even now that I'm working a lot in Blender, it would be cool if I could do some of that stuff in Nomad. If Nomad, again, figures out a way to make it fun, because Blender is, you know, it's not really like a fun application to use. That was long-winded.